Yo, YouTube. We back, man. We back with another video. Y'all already know who I am. If you don't, by now, I am Kevin Lamar, and this is my YouTube channel. It's not your fault. So, y'all already know what's going on. Of course, we got another topic today. And today's topic is going to be called flow. Yeah, so, we're going to talk about it, man, and I ain't got nothing else to say, so let's get into the video. Alright, YouTube. We back, man. So, we're gonna go and jump into it. For those of you that may be wondering why I call this video flaw, it's simply because we all got it. We all have them. But it's one that we all got. It's a very small group of people on this planet that does not have this flaw. And the flaw is called emotional handicap. So we all got this. Me too. I still suffer from an emotional handicap, and I did something that's gonna be beneficial to me today. I wrote down different areas that this emotional handicap plays out, because we think that everybody has their thing that they deal with, which is true. But like I said, we all have this one common thing in common. It's called the emotional handicap. And it plays out in a lot of different areas. I didn't write down everyone. I wrote down a few. So, the first one, we're going to talk about this flaw in its relationship. And we're going to use intimate relationships. Right? Okay. So, to those of you that may be asking, well, how does this emotional handicap play out in relationships? Well, in a lot of ways. When you're unwilling to do things that satisfies your spouse, when you're unwilling to go out of your way for your spouse, when you cheat on your spouse, just to name a few. So, cheating. How does emotional handicap play into cheating? Well, people not gonna want to admit this, and again, this gonna be something y'all don't like. We like to believe that when somebody steps out on us, that it's a conscious decision that they make it. So before I give this example, I'm going to say this. If you was to see a person in a wheelchair with their legs cut off, what kind of sense would it make for you to say, hey, stand up and walk over there? I can tell you, I'm on 99.999% of y'all not going to do that. Not even myself. Because the thing about it is, you can see something is wrong with this person. You can see in some shape, form, or fashion, this person doesn't have everything that you have. You can physically see it. But see, what we fuck up at is when it comes to the things that we can't see, which is your emotional. Your emotions, your feelings, your thoughts. I just said this in the last video. You can't see none of that shit. So, it may seem on the outside that, oh, when this person does this or when they say this, that, oh, that's just a choice they made. But the emotional handicap that this person has, they don't have the ability to say, oh, but when I see this fine-ass man, or when I see this, you know, just stacked-ass woman, I'm just going to ignore it and stay faithful. Everybody don't have the emotional stability to do that. They don't. You may not like it. The truth ain't pretty all the time. The only thing I'm telling y'all is the truth. This is something I had to come to terms with for myself. This is the only reason why I'm able to sit here and talk about it to y'all. So if your man done cheated on you, it's for a simple reason. He couldn't control whether he did or didn't. He couldn't help it. And I know this is a sensitive subject for a lot of y'all. So forgive me for laughing. Forgive me. Because I know some of y'all have really been hurt by this. So, you know, my deepest compassion go out to you. But I'm laughing because, like, we don't realize the dysfunction that's going on. And we really believe that all these fucked up situations that people end up in, they're choosing. They're really choosing to be this way. Let me tell y'all something. People, and this is regardless of what you want to believe. You can still choose to believe what you want to believe after I say this. That is on you. But as I said before, that is your stress. That is your anger. That is your unhappiness. That is your sadness. All of that shit. That's your shit. That you're holding on to. Okay. People are not consciously putting themselves in fucked up situations. Regardless of how much you want to believe it, they're not. You don't walk around and, for those of you that do, when you get mad, you don't choose to be mad. You don't choose to be mad. It's not a good feeling. You're very aware of that, which means you notice that that's not a good feeling. You don't choose to wake up and feel that way. It just happens to you. The same thing goes with a lot of this other shit that people do, that people say, how they react. This same mode of operating goes into those same situations. This is all I'm telling you. So, on the female side, you cheat on your man says, hey, baby, I would like for you to do more of this. You get him some type of response. I ain't doing that. You know, whatever it is that you say. You're not purposely trying to sabotage your relationship. This is an emotional impulse that takes you over. And you have a belief in this emotion. You have a belief in this thought. So if somebody was to tell you, hey, let that shit go. That's what you thinking right there, what you doing, what you saying you're not gonna do. That's not even important. Let it go. You may clearly understand that what they saying is true. But for whatever reason, you just can't let it go. You want to know why? Because this is an emotional handicap. You're a person in a chair with your fucking legs cut off and somebody is telling you to walk. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. So how else does an emotional handicap play out? Success. Being successful. The thing that's funny to me about this is it's so many people that's not living the life that they feel like they want to live. Listen to what I just said. The life they want to to live. So if you realize you want to live a certain way, but you're not, what's the fucking problem? What's the problem? If we have so much choice in the shit that we do, if we have so much control over what happens in our environment and what doesn't, what happens in us and what doesn't, if we have so much control, how could there be a life that you want to live and you're not living it? You wanna know why? Emotional fucking handicap. You're not choosing to sabotage your life. You're not choosing to make decisions that's going to take you farther and farther away from the life that you want to live. You're not choosing this. It's an emotional handicap. This emotional handicap comes from the same source that my channel come from, which is my purpose behind saying it's not your fault. It's a thing inside of you. It's a thing inside of all of us. It's in me too. It's a very small group of people on this planet that does not deal with this. And I will speak sometime down the line on what these people are. But it's in all of us. And this is the very reason why my channel is called It's Not Your Fault. It's because of this thing. So when you're sabotaging your success, when you're not doing the things that you know you need to do that's going to help you achieve your goals, I'm just telling you, regardless of how much you are aware of yourself, aware of your thought processes that you're going through moment to moment, it does not matter. If you're not taking the steps, if you're not taking the action that's going to put you in the life that you want to live, if you're not doing that, you're not making that choice. This is going to be very confusing to some of y'all. A lot of y'all. Most of y'all. It's going to be very confusing. Because this is the opposite of how you have been taught to look at these situations. But this is your emotional handicap. This is your flaw. So let's move on to another category. How else does an emotional handicap play out? I got an elementary example for you. In traffic. Yep, I know somebody gonna see this video. And you one of them people in traffic. It bugs you to be behind a slow person. It bugs you when traffic is backed up. It bugs you when traffic is heavy. It bugs you when people drive certain type of ways in traffic. It bugs you to just slow down when you see the light turn yellow. So instead of just slowing down, you hit the gas. Y'all know what I'm talking about. So with this, how does the emotional handicap come into play? Again, same thing. This is not something you're choosing to do. You don't choose to feel aggravated about traffic. Think about how silly that sounds. For you to wake up and say, oh, when I go out in traffic today, the motherfucker that's driving slow is the one I'm gonna get pissed off with. That light that keep changing from green to yellow when I'm almost through it. Yeah, I'm gonna get mad at that motherfucker too. You don't do this. This is not what you do. It just happens to you. And the reason it's happening to you is because of this thing, this flaw, which is your emotional handicap, which is also something that you have no control over. That's the tough part. That's the hard part to accept. It's coming to terms with the fact that these uncomfortable things keep happening to you, and it ain't nothing you can do about it. Well, let me give you something that could possibly help you out. You're not supposed to do anything about it. It's a part of you being a part of this thing that we call a body. But somehow we've been taught that, oh, if you're feeling some type of way, oh, you can close that out. You can turn that off. You can change it. Change happens in its own time. Change don't happen on your dime. So let me help you understand this. For those of you who said, oh, yes, it does. Okay. So right now, somebody is in the process of working on something. You know you need to change it. So now you're working on it. Let me ask you a question. If change happened when you wanted it to happen, why does it have to be a process? Why do you have to go through phases? If it's your decision, I'm just trying to make y'all think. If it's your decision, why does it have to be a process? Why have you been working on this thing for the last 3 months instead of the day that you realized it was an issue? Why have you been working on this thing for the last past 5 years rather than the day you realized it was an issue? Why didn't it change that day? Why is it still 3 months later? You still working on it. Why is it still 5 months later and you're still working on it? Because change happens of itself. It's not in your control. That thing that you think has the ability to change something, it don't. That thing that you think has the ability is that same thing that is your flaw, that is your emotional handicap, that is the source of the purpose of my channel. It is that thing that causes all of this extra dysfunction in your life. And guess what you call that thing? You call it me. Oh, that's me. That's Michelle. That's Kevin. That's Michael. That's me. That's what you call it. You identify yourself with your emotional... let me put it this way. You identify yourself as your emotional handicap. You just probably never realized it until now. You want to know why? Because nobody ever told you. And nobody ever broke it down in this way. Whatever the case may be. But this thing that you feel has the power to choose, this thing is your emotional handicap. This is the thing that I'm talking about all of us got. And it is the reason why we experience all of this unnecessary stress, anger, frustration, fear, whatever you want to call it. This is the reason. But guess what? Like I said already, you identify yourself as this thing. So think about that. You draw who you are. Because if somebody was to come to ask you, well, who are you? You're going to come up with this whole like little different list of things that you are. And this thing. It's not you. It's not you. It's who you've been taught to identify with. Because like I said, if you've seen my other videos, I mentioned there's a point before you was able to make decisions on your own. Decisions was being made for you. You was told what your name was. You was told that this thing was called the shoe that you put on your foot. The thing that you put on before the shoe is called the sock. You was taught that. So what you do now is through the filter of what you've already been taught. You didn't come up with your own creation. You didn't come up with your own language. The language you use now is the language you was taught already. The way you say hey to somebody is not something you created. No, it was taught to you. It was taught to you, man. And I'm laughing because, like, this stuff is so obvious. It is so obvious, but we just do not take time to think. So because we don't take time to think, everything that has been taught to us, and because we've seen it being duplicated by so many other people, we have identified ourselves with this thing. And this thing that we have identified ourselves with is the most dysfunctional shit that we possess as human beings. And then we were alone by ourselves, we stress the fuck out, we wonder why. Why I can't change? Why I just can't get rid of this? Why I just can't let this feeling go? Why I can't just be okay when somebody fuck over me? Why do I have to be mad? Why do my whole day have to get turned upside down because this person said this thing to me? It's because you've identified yourself with the thing that creates all of this shit. And it is called your flaw. Your emotional handicap. So, I have a couple other things on this list that this thing plays into. And I'm not going go into, I'm just going to tell you what they are. The other one is raising your children. Another one is you working on your job. And another one is weight loss. And these just are examples. It's a ton of ways that this emotional handicap comes into play. This is just some of the stuff I wrote down. So, I feel like at this point, is why I draw the conclusion to the video. If you have any questions, if you're confused about anything, if it's something specific you would like for me to talk about, drop it in the comments. But also in the process, make sure you hit that like button. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Make sure you turn on that notification bell. I enjoyed y'all, man. I hope y'all enjoyed me. Flaw. Your emotional handicap. See y'all next week.